What's up, guys? Luke here from Luke's Points and Miles, and today I realize that we are a little over a week away from American Airlines actually rolling out their new status program. Now, we've gone over the new program a couple times on the channel in the last few weeks, so if you need to catch up on that, check out our videos on American Airlines. We're big fans of American Airlines on the channel, so we'd like to keep up to date. March 1st, the new program actually launches, but we've been able to accumulate loyalty points since the first of the year. So very soon we will have documentation on exactly how many loyalty points we've earned, and then we can kind of adjust our strategies accordingly. So today I want to review the American Airlines credit cards from Citibank. These three cards are likely going to be the most popular American Airlines cards for us right now. There are consumer and business cards from Barclays, and Citi has a business American Airlines card, but for today we just want to stick with these three as I think they'll be the most popular for the majority of people. Now, if you're new to the channel, we talk about credit cards, points, miles, cashback, travel, crypto assets. If you're interested in that sort of thing, slap that subscribe button. We are a growing channel and we're having a lot of fun seeing those numbers go up, and it's a very exciting time to be part of the channel. We have made a lot of improvements to our thumbnails and to our logistical aspect of the channel. And if you get any value or entertainment out of this video, hit that like button. Matter of fact, hit that like button anyway, because we have been working so hard on our thumbnails and our aesthetics for the channel. And that will help us with the YouTube algorithm, and it'll help us get this information out to people who can actually use it. Now, guys, I know your time is super valuable, so I want to dive right in. But before I get to the cards, I want to make a note that all of these are MasterCards. If you use programs like Plastiq to hit your minimum spend or to help you put extra spend on the card for things like American Airlines status, you'll find that MasterCard credit cards are eligible for things like mortgages and car payments, which is a strategy I'm currently using to hit gold status with American Airlines. Check our link below for Plastiq. You may be eligible for a discount on the fees for using our link. With that out of the way, first up is the Citi American Airlines Advantage Mile Up card. This is going to be your entry level, no annual fee card from Citi. And this card, despite having no annual fee, has a decent little bonus. 10,000 American Airlines miles and a $50 statement credit bonus for spending just $500 in the first 3 months. Basically, Citi will pay you to get this card and to use it. I've mentioned this card before on the channel, and I think it's a great little no annual fee card, especially for the anti-annual fee crowd and for beginners. Now, what does this card earn? The card earns 2 miles per dollar spent on grocery stores, a big category for a lot of us, 2 miles per dollar spent on American Airlines purchases, and 1 mile per dollar on everything else. This card also gives the holder 25% off in-flight purchases. So pretty basic card, but it is a great tool if you're interested in airline status with American. One thing to note, guys, this card has a 3% foreign transaction fee. We always talk about the foreign transaction fee if you are going to fly overseas or out of the country, something to be very careful about. Now we'll move on to some of the more juicier cards. For those of you that fly American Airlines, the next in the list is the Citi Advantage Platinum Select World Elite MasterCard. That is a mouthful, but I think this is a pretty good card. The bonus for this card is 50,000 American Airlines miles for just $2,500 spend in 3 months. To me, that is a great bonus. I value American Airlines miles fairly high. I normally get at least 1.6 or 1.7 cents per point on these miles. Super valuable and super versatile because American Airlines has great partners. What does the card earn? This card earns 2 miles per dollar spent on gas stations, dining, and American Airlines. 1 mile per dollar for everything else. So this card has a $99 annual fee that is waived in year one. Let's check out and see if these benefits can outweigh that fee. This card comes with a $125 American Airlines flight discount after you spend $20,000 and renew your card. Now, normally I would not have suggested that. However, with the new loyalty points status earning system, it may be worth it to put $20,000 on this card, depending on how much status you want to earn with American Airlines. Now, this card will get you your first checked bag for free and up to four of your companions on the same itinerary. That could be tremendously valuable if you check bags. This card comes with preferred boarding. Now, a lot of people kind of blow off the preferred boarding, but if you're like me and you carry on your bag and you take a lot of fairly short flights, if you're not in the first four or five boarding groups, you're likely to run out of overhead space and you'll have to gate check your bag. I really recommend never gate checking your bag. It's amazing how some of these airlines can lose it without going anywhere. Now, this card will also get you 25% off on in-flight purchases when they come back. Now, this card has no foreign transaction fees. If you're a fan of the channel, we always recommend carrying a no foreign transaction fee Visa or MasterCard whenever you leave the United States. I am a huge Amex guy, but I always carry a no foreign transaction fee MasterCard or Visa when I leave the country. This card can fill that spot. So if you fly American Airlines, then these benefits will absolutely outweigh that annual fee until you start earning status. Next up, we have Citi's American Airlines Premium Card. Now, lots of folks have mixed feelings on this card, so let's take a really deep dive and a hard look at it and see what we think. This is the Citi Advantage Executive World Elite MasterCard. Giant names for these cards, which I don't mind. This card has a bonus of 50,000 miles for $5,000 spend in 3 months. And you're saying, Luke, wait a minute. The last card had the same bonus for half the spend. This card is targeted to a much different audience. And as we go through the card, you'll see why. This card severely lacks in earning potential. You will get 2 miles spent on American Airlines purchases and 1 mile spent on everything else. This is a very different card than the last one. And this card also comes with a $450 premium annual fee. Now, that is a huge annual fee for a co-branded airline card. What could they possibly offer that could offset that fee? Well, the big deal for this card is it comes with an Admirals Club membership. Now, with the Admirals Club membership, you have access to the American Airlines Admirals Club lounges, and you can bring up to 2 guests or your immediate family with you into these lounges. Now, depending on how you value that, is whether that $450 annual fee will be worth it, at least up to now. But I will say that for regular Advantage members, an Admirals Club membership is $650 per year. This card also gives you your first check bag for free and up to 8 people in your itinerary. So you could end up getting 8 or 9 free check bags each way. That type of cost really adds up, especially if you fly a lot of American or you have a big family. This card gives the holder an enhanced airport experience. You will be eligible for priority check-in and priority boarding. If anyone has experienced that, I would love to hear about exactly what that is. Is it just a different line to check in and check your bags? Even if that's the case, that can save you a half an hour or 45 minutes every time you check in for a flight. That could be worth $450 to some people. This card gives you a statement credit for your TSA pre-check or global entry. Now, as always on the channel, we give you a pro tip. Global entry comes with TSA PreCheck, so in my opinion, if you're going to leave the country ever, it is worth going the extra mile and just getting the global entry. This card also gives you 25% off American Airlines in-flight purchases, and it gives you a dedicated concierge. Again, if anyone has used that dedicated concierge, I would love to hear about your experience. I have had a couple, I guess you would say, emergency moments with American Airlines as far as flights were concerned. And those were moments that it would have been really nice to just be able to call a dedicated concierge. I think that benefit is probably really overrated, and I would really love to see what that's all about. Now, some more things about this card. It used to have spending incentives for earning status with the old program. I would be really curious if American Airlines and Citi didn't return some type of spending incentive as part of this new program beginning in March. If you're interested in this card, really keep your eyes on it as this new loyalty points status program rolls out. And if that wasn't enough, this card does have somewhat of a superpower. You can add up to 10 authorized users for this card. What that means is up to 10 extra people will then have an Admirals Club membership. Now, Admirals Club membership, as we said before, normally costs $650 a year. So if you have family members or very, very close friends that would value something like an Admirals Club membership, I'm sure they wouldn't mind helping you out with that $450 annual fee, if you see what I'm going with this. Also, I'm very trustworthy, so if anyone has an extra authorized user card they could throw at me, I would definitely help you out with that annual fee. So there you have it, guys. All three consumer cards from City. Which one fits you best? I can see a case for any of the three for the right person. But if you want American Airlines status this year, you're likely going to need an American Airlines credit card, since a large portion of the status earning will be based on spend. Also, American Airlines has a terrific shopping portal. We always recommend using a shopping portal. Normally, we recommend Rakuten, but if you are attempting to earn status with American Airlines, then I would definitely say, at least for this year, or at least until your strategy changes, use the American Airlines shopping portal and start stacking huge amounts of American Airlines miles. I've already said they're super valuable. Now, guys, my question is this. For those of you that are trying to earn status this year on American Airlines, we don't actually know how many loyalty points we've accrued in January and February. If you are trying to do that, I want you to comment below. How many loyalty points do you think you've accrued? I'd be real interested to see how far some of us have gotten to gold status or platinum status. And then I would like to see that real number, to see how close we are of being accurate with what we think we've earned. So guys, again, if you get any value at all from this video, don't forget to give us a like. And if you've stayed around all the way to the end, thanks.